Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be reacting to why people never like white women. Wow, this is gonna be great. So without further ado, let's get started.
Let's talk white women here, shall we? Let's talk white women. White women, you're amazing. Amazing, your accomplishments over the last few years. I gotta tell you, the way white women somehow hijack the woke movement, generals around the world should be analyzing this. Just to refresh your memory, the woke movement was supposed to be about people of color not getting opportunities, the at-bats that they deserved, finally making that happen. And it was about that for about 8 seconds. And then somehow, white women swung their Gucci-booted feet over the fence of oppression and stuck themselves at the front of the line. I don't know how they did it. I've never heard so much complaining in my life from white women. My life is so hard with my SUV and my heated seats. You have no idea what it's like to be me. Trash and white guys, the nerve. Where's the camera? The nerve of you white women. Listen, I don't want to speak ill of my bitches here, okay? I don't. But let's go back in history here, okay? You guys stood by us toxic white males through centuries of our crimes against humanity. You rolled around in the blood money. And occasionally, when you wanted to sneak off and hook up with a black dude, if you got caught, you said it wasn't consensual. Yeah, that's what you did. That's what you did. So why don't you shut up, sit down next to me, and take your talking to. Thank you. So, I don't know what it is. I don't know what the fuck is going on. But I think white women started it. It's the worst. The fucking worst. It's all they do is bitch, moan, and complain. I had no idea how difficult it was to be a white woman in the United States of America. Evidently, it's really difficult. Yeah, they're always bitching. Do you have any idea what it's like to be me? Well, I imagine it would be slightly less awesome than my life. What happened to you today, sweetheart, huh? Did they not chill your rosé? You know? Was the trolley not running down at the mall? What happened? No, it's unreal. I'm really fucking annoyed how white women have the fucking balls to throw my white privilege in my face, you know? Start to separate themselves from these white males with their white male privilege. It's like, bitch, you're sitting in the jacuzzi with me. The fuck are you talking about? Yeah, quit your fucking whining. Look, right out of the gate, all right? If you live in some honey boo-boo lifestyle on the Appalachian Trail, you know, your uncle just banged you in the dirt, all right, I can listen to you. Now, one of my fantasies is I want to drive by like a woman's rally and just say the most sexist shit I can think of just to watch them lose their minds. And I'll just drive by real slow and be like, yeah, why don't you get back in the kitchen where you belong? Just to look in their rearview mirror, watching them flipping out in the road, spinning around like Leatherface at the end of Texas Chainsaw Massacre, like... Yeah, no, it's a very, I don't know, times are changing, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, Michelle Obama's doing an arena tour. That's another thing going on. I'm gonna say that again. Michelle Obama is doing an arena tour. She's not playing comedy clubs. She's doing arenas. When did first ladies start acting like they got elected? You know? Dude, being a first lady, that's not a fucking job.
It is.
Right? Look how quiet is it in here. Why is it so fucking quiet? You think that's a job? It's not a fucking job. Dude, if you really think it's a job, just look at her. right? Look at Obama. When that guy got elected, he looked like he was about 41 years old. When he left office, that guy looked like he was about 73, right?
I agree with that. You see, I wanted to ask this question. Why is it that when presidents, you know, come into office, they look a bit younger, a bit, you know, fresher, handsome. But when they are leaving, they look older, like way, way older. It's like they added 20 years on top of their age. Like, I've been asking because, you know, as a president in my country, you know, before he entered, he was looking so young and vibrant. But just a short period of, I think, that was it 4 years or 8 years, yeah. He looked way older. He was looking like more of my grandfather than my father. I was like, what's happened? You were supposed to be enjoying. You see, being a president is like kind of the highest, you know, I think, hierarchy or that you ever be, you know, in a country. Because every other person look up to you. You know, you don't report to anyone. At least in Africa, you have, you know, the full control. You make your decision, you know, they stand, you bring up policy. So I felt like, you know, you'll be a little bit younger, you know, looking more polished and, you know, handsome. But it's like the position is draining them. Because, yeah, I know they are carrying the workload of the entire country on their head. But guys, you have people around to be running those errands for you. You are there to just, you know, command, you know, do this, let me make this decision, let's try to improve this. That is it. You are not doing the heavy lifting. You see, you are there to sign check, you know, approve contracts. That is your duty. But it seems like it's more, you know, difficult that I'm seeing, because it's like I'm seeing it as an easy job. But people that have ventured into such field, they are looking, you know, they are looking older than they're supposed to. I don't know. And you know, when it comes to, you know, the first lady being a job, I feel it's a full-time job, because you know, starting from the campaign, you have to be there, you know, to support your husband, you know, to make sure you talk to the women. You see, that is it. Because in my country, I see the first lady functioning so much. You see, before you get to that position, I see them holding, you know, campaign, you know, talking to their fellow women, to talk to other people, to vote for their husband. You see, they go to church. You see, they try to convince people, you know, to campaign for their husband. So why would I allow my wife to go through that, you know, sacrifice? Then when I become the president, I won't, you know, give her the opportunity, you know, to handle affairs. Because majority of people, they want to come back for the second tenure. So by the time you are privileged to become the president, you need to keep on advising your wife to go out there, you know, still keep on campaigning, talking to those people, you know, at least making them feel comfortable. Because you can't just become the president and abandon those people that campaign for you, because you want to come back for a second tenure. So I feel it's a full-time job. You see, like, it's a continual process. So long as you are in the office as the man, the lady need to use that privilege. You see, because it's just a short period of maybe 8 years or 4 years and you're out. So let her use the power. Because yeah, I discovered Michelle Obama was like the first female wife of a president that I really felt her impact. Like, I heard of her. She was like everywhere, you know, you hear Michelle Obama, you know, former president. I did not really feel the impact of their, you know, first lady. But for her, I felt it. Maybe because Barack Obama was the first black president, maybe that was why I felt it, because she was, you know, there to make sure her impact was being felt by so many. Please pardon me. Let's go back to the video.
Look at Michelle. She looks younger now than she did when that dude got elected. What has she done for the last 8 years? Yeah, other than lay in a giant vat of Illuminati-level lotion, just sit there floating. A couple hours, a shapeshifter comes in and dumps another bucket on her. She pops her head up. Hey, Bam Bam, tell Stevie Wonder to come down and play some songs tonight. Now, I found out she's doing a tour because she's doing a book tour. Yeah, she wrote a book. She wrote a book about not having a job. I gotta read that fucking book. Chapter 1, how to know if a dick tastes presidential. Eat your way through all that local representative cock and get to the big swinging dick in the room. Now, say what you want about Republican presidents, but they got their first ladies in line. They do. Dude, George W. was president for 8 years. 8 years. I don't even know his wife's name. What was it, Abigail or some shit? Maggie? No clue. Donald Trump's wife stands behind him like a giant meerkat, like... Bill Clinton was president, his wife never shut up. Ah, I want to do health care. Ah. He fucked around on her so much, he's like, all right, whatever, just do it. But I'm telling you right now, I'm gonna check out that fucking tour. I gotta see what that's all about. You know? Who opens? Who opens on that fucking tour? Was it Oprah Winfrey's husband? You know? Does he fucking come out and talk about what it's like to walk her dogs? I do it easiest, and I gotta bring him around. Look, I'm sure that there's some feminist in the crowd right now not appreciating this joke, feeling triggered, feeling like they need to fucking put out a hashtag or some shit and be brave and speak out. You know what? You're full of shit. You are. All those feminists are full of shit. Because I'm going to tell you right now, someday, there's going to be the first woman president. All right? Which means, you don't even know what her fucking platform is, and you automatically cheer. It's got the same genitalia. Fucking... I'm telling you, they're not smart people. Feminists, they're not as smart as they're coming off. I'm telling you. Someday, there's gonna be... By the way, this is gonna be my last show ever by the time this fucking thing comes out. Someday, there's gonna be the first female president, which means there's gonna be the first male first lady. Right?
First month.
And you wait. You fucking wait. The first time that dude opens, these feminists, they're on me. You shut the fuck up! You shut the fuck up! It is her time now. It is her time. She was elected, not you. Go pick out some plates, bitch. You are the first lady. He's gonna get treated like Tom Arnold when he was with Roseanne. Secret Service name will be like appendix or doesn't matter. Not worthy of protecting. Just entered the Oval Office. Not worthy of protecting.
Guys, this is nice. This is nice. You see, I love the fact that Bilbo, whenever he wants, you know, to say anything related to comedy, he just pick a word. You see, now he's talking about white women and he elaborates on it. You see, find things that will make you laugh. With just that, you know, let's say a statement. But anyway, I love this so much. And another thing is, well, we men, we are trying, no matter your color. You see, we are trying. We are really doing our best when it comes to, you know, we are doing our best in general. Because if anything is going to happen today, it's still us that will bear the cross. You see, two country fights, we are the one going to fight. Okay, let's say the house is burning. We are going to be the one, you know, to be the last person to leave the house because we have to make sure our children are safe. Sometimes valuables are safe, you see. But we take that risk and many more. And we don't, you know, call on the ladies to come and take this for us. A man will go out there, work, find money, settle down, you know, like get married, take care of his family. When he gets to retirement age, he tries best to survive with or without his children assisting. he's ready to bear the pain, to bear the loss and everything. Where I know women are doing their part. You see, when it comes to the part of, you know, being there for the children, they are there. You know, that's why I say we are all built differently. So I'm not expecting a man to be crying, okay, my wife, I need your help. I'm tired of crying this cross on my own. No, we shoulder it. We carry it. So when I say women doing things and like they feel like, okay, they want to be like us because they feel our life is better. No, I won't want to do what a woman is doing. You see, because I know it's not easy for them. Neither will I want a woman, you know, to carry the burden I'm carrying on my head. You see, because I know there are things I do and do them easily. You see, especially when it comes to, you know, Africa. You see, there are so many hectic work that we won't advise our ladies to do. Even if they will be willing to do it, but we'll feel like, now let's do it on our own. Well, the way he talks about white lady, their privilege, you know, now there are a few things you can say to the lady that are not offensive, you know, before you say things, you have to pick your weight. Because the next thing you will see maybe is a lawsuit or you'll be arrested, you know. So nowadays we are so, so careful, because if you like a certain lady, there are ways in which you even approach her. You see, if not, it will look like harassment. So we guys, our rights have been limited. Seriously, it's like no one is speaking for us. We are limited to so many things. It's like I said, our rights are coming down every day, you know. We can't do this, we can't do this anymore, we can't do this anymore. But it's like, because we are not speaking out, it's like everyone feel everything is okay with us. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comment section. If it is the first time visiting my channel, click on the subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and remember this.